What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about renaming the local administrative account using Intune. So let's get right into it. All right, so let's log into our Microsoft 365 Admin Center. On the left-hand side, let's click on Show All. From here, we are going to locate and click on Endpoint Manager. It's going to load this guy up right here. On the left-hand side, we are going to click on Devices. And underneath By Platform, we are going to click on Windows. Once that loads up, underneath Windows Policies, we are going to click on Configuration Profiles. We're going to locate and click on Create, and then pick New Policy. We're going to get a side menu for the platform. We're going to click on the drop-down menu, and we're going to select Windows 10 and later. For the profile type, let's click on the drop-down menu, and we are going to select Settings Catalog. We're going to click on Create, and let's give our profile a name. Now, the name that I chose and provided was the following. This is really up to you, kind of self-explanatory of what the policy is going to do. I'm going to click on Next. For the configuration settings, I'm going to click on Add Settings, and from here, we're going to type in the following rename administrator. We're going to hit enter or click on search, and we're going to select local policy security options. And that's going to give you an additional option at the bottom. And we're going to enable or give it a check mark, account rename administrative account. So once you check that off, we're going to exit out of that. And then we need to configure it. It says accounts rename administrative account administrator. By default, that is the name of your local administrative account. You're able to change it to whatever you want. And this is what I'm going to provide within my environment. So once you do that, click on next. For tags, I typically do not do tags within my profiles, so I just leave it as is, and I click on next. For assignments, I am going to add a group, so click on add groups and select your group. I'm going to push out this profile to all my autopilot devices group, and I am going to click on select. From here, click on next. Nice little review. Click on create, and on the upper right hand side, your policy was created. If you give it some time or refresh the page, you should see your new policy. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.